Good evening. The state television company in Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. An open letter to the High Commissioner for Diaspora Affairs Zareh Sinanian. U.S. House of Representatives adopted the recognition resolution on genocide against Armenians. Attempt to destroy the 3,000-year-old cuneiform inscription of Menua in Karin. Fifth annual reading dedicated to Grigor Narekatsi completed at Matenadaran. Steps are being made to promote the movie Gate to Heaven worldwide. Republic of Armenia Diaspora Commissioner Zareh Sinanian. I don't know about my tech. The strategic goal is to live as Armenians in our own homeland. Recognition is a tactical step in a long series of steps we will undertake as a people. It is more a national security issue. What comes after Turkish recognition? The only one entity that can implement policy and politics is Republic of Armenia. It has to be the state. With respect to Turkey, I assure you in the future it's going to be with Armenia and not with respect to the diaspora. We say that the diaspora wants to struggle for Western Armenia, but on its own, how is the struggle going to take place? How is the diaspora going to return Western Armenia? If you can give me an answer to this issue, I'd love to hear it. But there is a state of Armenia that has all the institutions that it has and also conducts foreign policy. This is a much more powerful tool. Andranik Gasparyan. Granted, we have lost Western Armenia. Today, we have Armenia and Artsakh as our homeland. Who better to address the Armenia that we lost than the diaspora? Whose pedigree is Western Armenia? We don't want to speak in the past tense about Armenia as we do with regard to Western Armenia. According to Resolution 260, adopted by the General Assembly of the United Nations on December 9, 1948, the Genocide Convention entered into force 12 January 1951, respecting the provisions of Article 13. And according to Article 11 of the Declaration of Independence of the Republic of Armenia, the Republic of Armenia will support the issue of international recognition of the genocide against Armenians in Ottoman Turkey and Western Armenia. And according to the UN Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous People of September 30, 2007, in which 143 states, including the Republic of Armenia, voted, the indigenous people, Armenian people of Western Armenia and Cilicia, were subjected to genocide. This one is approved under the 3 points of the UN Convention on the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide. The Republic of Western Armenia can demand compensation for the Turkish government because, according to international law, the borders of the continuous state of Armenian state on the territory of Western Armenia with Turkey are established by the terms of the Treaty of Sèvres 1920 and by the arbitrary award of Woodrow Wilson together with the Allied powers which regulate the rights of Armenians in Western Armenia. According to the international law, only descendants of the indigenous Armenian people of Western Armenia and survivors of the genocide can claim compensation. The genocide was committed in order to emancipate those lands from indigenous Armenian population and take possession of their property. Organized in a state system, therefore Armenians of Western Armenia can, as a state and as a successor of indigenous people who have been subjected to genocide and deported, put their land claims before Turkey and international tribunals. We should also consider our brothers and sisters who have been converted to Islam. As children of the indigenous people, we can raise an international issue of human rights, something that today's Republic of Armenia cannot do, which step can be seen as a violation of international boundaries, just as it was with the Artsakh issue. Artsakh is the best example of the right of the indigenous people to self-determination. National Assembly of Western Armenia. The U.S. House of Representatives adopted the recognition resolution on genocide against Armenians based on voting results. There will be no changes in the resolution anymore. A total of 405 congressmen supported the resolution, 11 legislators spoke out against. Although the U.S. has several times recognized genocide against Armenians through presidential proclamations and House resolutions, this is the first time the full Congress passed a measure making it U.S. policy. There was made an attempt to break around 3,000-year-old Armenian cuneiform inscription in the Yazidi Tash village of Khorasan province of Karin, Western Armenia. Professor Alpaslan Ceylan noted that the historic monument can be destroyed by the vandals at any time and called on the authorities to take action. Ceylan, who is currently doing research work, visited the village and witnessed the vandalism of historic monument. According to him, this can be done either by vandalism or by a group seeking to destroy the historical traces of Western Armenia. At the end of the cuneiform inscription, it is written, "Whoever destroys this writing, may God curse him." This week, the fifth annual readings dedicated to Grigor Narekatsi were completed at the Mastropanchtos Institute of Ancient Manuscripts Matenadaran, which were initiated by Hrachat Tamrazian, the former director of Matenadaran. The present director of Matenadaran, Bahan Terghavundian, mentioned that during these 5 years of Narekatsi readings or international conferences, not only were sounded remarkable lectures, but there were presentations of new Narekatsi books and Narekatsi works in foreign languages. During these conferences, a rare manuscript belonging to Narekatsi pen survived the eventual destruction. Copied in the Metsupa Monastery in 3008, was presented to the scientific circles. The steps for the worldwide distribution of the movie Gate to Heaven are made. Director Jivan Avetisyan and the German co-producers presented the film within the framework of EWIP. According to the movie's Facebook page, only 28 of the 150 bids from 59 countries were selected, including Gate to Heaven, which captured the attention of the Electoral Commission for High Quality and Unique Artistic Commentary on History. EWIP is a new way for the movie Gate to Heaven to be released worldwide. Now let us present to your attention a song by Agung Hamut. You can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.